to reflect on today's theme as we read in the book of 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7. Who is this Holy Spirit? While we are living in this world of sin, Satan and death, who is this Holy Spirit? What is his role in our lives? What is the role of this Holy Spirit in our lives? We read in the book of 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7. For God did not give us the spirit of cowardice. Coward means fear, timidity, not willing to do anything for God. You are lethargic. You are thrown away into your own little world. You make your own little world. You have your own desires and you are being tied up with that. You don't want to come up. You are always backside. No, leave me free. No. Leave me free. Covered means you are not willing to face life. This is what the evil spirit does in the world. Brother Augustine Jepakumar was talking to me. Another incident. When he went to Germany, he was sitting in the train. And as he was sitting, he saw another white man sitting next to him and busy in reading something. He could not understand. Then he understood it's written in German. So he wanted to have a conversation. So he took his biscuit like an Indian style. He opened the biscuit and gave him one. Sir, can you? That man said, I'm fasting. So brother understood that this man knows English. He said, you are fasting? Yes, very happy. How many days you fast? I fast 2 days in a week. I see. He was so happy. To which church you go? I go to the church of Satan. Huh? Satan church. You are going to Satanic church and you are fasting. For what you are fasting? Every servant of God, every fellow who preaches the so-called Bible should fall into the spirit of lust. Every family that works for God has to be broken. And there should be confusion and fear and disturbance in the life of every Christian. For these three reasons, we fast twice in a day, twice in a week. Do you know the enemy is preparing a band of people to work against the kingdom and the so-called the chosen children of God? They are busy in their own little world. They live their life. They want to make them happy themselves. That is the trick of the enemy. Attack of the enemy to make them zero. They do not know. The so-called children of God, Christian community, they are become cowards. They are become frightened people. They are being constantly attacked by the enemy. And the people do not know it is the attack of the enemy. And people do not know they are on the war. They are fired. Because when the Holy Spirit comes, he comes with glory and power. Whereas the evil spirit, you will not know how does he come inside you. But when you say go away, he will not go. He will show his color. He will throw you into the fire. He will bring something out of your mouth. He will make you falling. Yes, different way he will. Suddenly he will make you to hit at your wife. For what? Hit at your TV with hard work you have earned. You will abuse your own father. Why? You are fired. You do not know. But now we will understand what is the Spirit, Holy Spirit does. Number one, he protects his children who are attacked by the fear, who are not willing to stand for him with the cowardice. They try to keep themselves back. No, not me. We read in the book of 1 Kings chapter 18, the servant of God Elijah is faced with a situation where 420 prophets are standing against him. The Lord says, you and your God together is a majority. You and your God, if joined together, you are the majority always. Because God is who made heaven and earth. Let any amount of people come, they are only belong to the earth. But your God belongs to God, earth and heaven. So man can fight from down only. At the most, the enemy can fight from the akasham, sky. But God will fight from heaven. So the Holy Spirit comes to protect his children who are attacked by the spirit of covetousness, who are attacked by timidity, who are attacked by fright, fear, and tie them up with the fear. Yes, when Elijah has to fight against 420 people, he looked upon the Lord. He began to fast and said, Lord, I'm going to the place where the challenge is going to take place, where they challenged that I will kill a bull, you also kill a bull. We have to put in both of our altars and we have to pray. I will pray to my God, you pray to your God. First you pray to your God. If your God is the real God, let the fire come from your God. You should not put the fire. I will not put the fire. I will pray to my God and my God will give the fire. Challenge is over. The whole town has come already to that place. Black magicians, the soothsayers, the Baal prophet, they said, easy, we'll just make a small prayer. Our evil spirit that is in the sky, he will give us the power, we will bring fire. It's not a big thing. There, they did not prepare, they just came. But Elijah went the previous night. He climbed on the mountain. He was fasting and praying. And he covered the place with the presence of God. If you fill yourself with the spirit of God, the evil spirit will not go inside you. The tragedy of God's servants and the children of God is they don't fill themselves. They don't get up themselves and fill themselves every minute with the presence of God. So the presence of evil easily peeps, gets into the life of God's children, gets into the mind of God's children. And when they are attacked, they look towards God. God says, move from inside to out. Be filled with my presence. And you move. 1 Corinthians 10:31. Every minute, praise God, thank God, be conscious of the spirit of God in you and move with him, celebrate him. But man tries to come from out to in. His namesake is the child of God. He allows the family problem. He allows that what's happening in the nation. He allows what's happening, the disturbance. Everything becomes part of his life. He allows everything to hold him. And everything is pulling him. And that moment, he tries to come inside. With the darkness, he is trying to reach light. Rather, God asks us, possess my light and overcome the darkness. Your life, your call of a Christian is constantly train your mind to be in the presence. Constantly empower yourself with the spirit and understand the works of the enemy and conquer the enemy. Our life is from inside to out. The lotus that is inside, it comes out. Yes. It is not from outside to in. You can't allow yourself to be drowned in the outside world. You become victim. You become broken. Lord, my family has become like this. That is what the man from outside to in. I'm being attacked by this. You become a helpless man. You become a beggar. Your prayer life becomes a begging life. Lord, please help me. If you don't, what will happen to me? Whereas if you move from within, you are filled with the presence. You know for truth that your God is a living God. He is a loving Father. He is a mighty God. He is God Almighty. And he is a God of wisdom, all-knowing. Sarva Jnani, Sarvandaryami, Sarva Shaktudu. So these three things are every minute haunts your mind. Your God is a loving Father. Your God is almighty. Your God is a God of wisdom who is present everywhere. When you move from within, as soon as you get up, every time when you get up, when you get time, you are in touch with your God. That's what you read in Psalm 46 verse 10. Be still and know that I am your God. What is your God? My God is a loving Father. My God is all powerful who made heaven and the earth. My God is a God of wisdom and knowledge. All knowing. Sarvajnani. Yes. If you are conscious of these three aspects and then you move, you look at the problem with the light of God and say, what if I don't care? My God knows everything. Nothing can happen to me without the knowledge of my God. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.